What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Ecoli Espresso, and welcome to another Advanced Warfare video here today on my channel. What we got for you guys today, it's going to be in two parts, kind of, I think. This first one is going to be my thoughts and my opinions on it, and a breakdown coming later, but what we got today to talk about is the Advanced Warfare co-op reveal. So, earlier today, we got a trailer on Call of Duty's channel entitled Official Call of Duty Advanced Warfare Power Changes Everything Trailer. Now, I'll put that link down in the description below because I cannot put it up on my screen for you guys to watch in video because people are getting striked. Activision is actually doing a very vigilant job of hunting down everybody using this gameplay at the moment and striking them, so I'm not going to risk a copyright strike over something that you can watch either simultaneously or previously or beforehand watching this video just by watching the link down in the description below. Now, as for making a second video today, I'm not sure if it's going to be up today or if it'll be up tomorrow. That's yet to be determined here. It's probably going to be depending on what time this video goes up, because I don't really like uploading too late. It doesn't do too great with sub boxes and all that kind of stuff. But today, for sure, though, I definitely wanted to bring you guys my thoughts on all of this, because if you guys are on Twitter at all, you'll notice that it's not the most peaceful of place right now. Pretty much the entire community is spewing hate everywhere towards Michael Condrey, Glenn Schofield, and the entire Sledgehammer crew, and personally, I think it's totally unnecessary. First off, the game mode itself looks a lot better than the standard Modern Warfare 3 survival because there's a lot more to do in it. Yes, there is still the standard armory where you can buy weapons and then stuff for your exosuits and all that kind of stuff, but it's not the same exact thing that we've seen in Modern Warfare 3. There's different objectives that you have to do, all that kind of stuff. Definitely a lot better in terms of adding on to it. And at the very heart and soul of it all, it is the core basis of zombies, which is what everybody seemingly wants. Take away the theme of these zombies and you'd have the exact same thing as survival. So here's the thing, even though thematically it's definitely different and it's something that may not be as cool as zombies or demons or dinosaurs or whatever it was that people thought it was going to be, it's the same basic idea. And personally, I don't have a problem with that at all. Modern Warfare 3 Survival definitely was not my favorite of the co-ops, and it's something that personally, going back and playing, I wouldn't play at all. I'd probably take Spec Ops from Modern Warfare 2 over Survival in Modern Warfare 3. But at the same point in time, this is now upgraded differently. I'm not saying that I'm gonna absolutely love it come November, and personally, I'd probably prefer to have zombies or cyborgs or whatever it is that people wanted. But am I going to bash everybody on Twitter or say that I'm not gonna get the game? No, I'm not gonna do that. That's absurd to me. Personally, that's still two out of three giant pieces of the puzzle that I love, because this trailer also showed off campaign and multiplayer as well. So some of the things that I've seen regarding the game and people saying that it's just not worth it anymore, I really don't think there's any place to judge until you've played the game. Two out of the three is still extremely entertaining, and for the most part, a ton of people don't even go into the co-op modes of the game. The dominant number of players are just on multiplayer, while others are on campaign for the first week or so of launch in the new title. So this is something that, if you don't really like it, you don't have to play it. It's nothing to cancel your pre-order over. It's nothing to say, I'm never buying a Call of Duty over again. It's one game mode. Here's the next thing that I want to lead into, because it's something that isn't set in stone. It's not something that's guaranteed, but it's something that could be done because we've seen it be done before. Looking back at previous titles, mainly Call of Duty Ghosts, and that's actually the only one that's done it, Extinction was not actually announced until a week or so right before launch. Like, literally, it was a last second announcement to the community, and it's something that was a hell of a lot better than what we had branded as co-op at the time, and that was Squads. Upon it being announced, Squads was the co-op mode for Call of Duty Ghosts. I don't know if any of you guys remember that or in your fits of rage at the moment care to remember that, but that's exactly what happened. We thought that Squads was going to be the co-op mode for Call of Duty Ghosts, the four-player survival wave type thing that we saw in Ghosts. That was all that we had at the time. Extinction was not announced until right before the game dropped. And I'm very glad it did, because Extinction actually was pretty good. Didn't live up to Zombies, but it was still a lot better than Squads. And so what I'm saying is, don't really just say I'm done with the game and all the hype because the co-op mode wasn't exactly what I thought. There still is time for there to be a fourth mode announced, especially because why would we want to revert back to three if there was four in the last title? Now, again, I'm not saying that any of this is set in stone. This is just wild thinking right now, and perhaps maybe I'm the crazy one at this point. But knowing Sledgehammer, how they like to please the community, and to go even a little bit in depth more, Michael Condrey, when's the last time that you've known him to not be a little bit more sneaky in his ways? Personally, I really think there is something else hidden up the sleeve of Sledgehammer, and if there isn't, well, I'm not gonna be too destroyed by it because we still have a kick-ass game in front of us. So I guess this video has kind of turned into more of a counter rant against rants, but I guess that's my thoughts and opinions on the matter. The game mode itself, like I said, survival wasn't my first choice, but again, I'm not going to be destroyed by it. It looks like a great step up compared to the Modern Warfare 3 survival that we've known. So I'm willing to give this a chance, I'm willing to let it go, and I'm still extremely looking forward to Advanced Warfare come this November. So that's been my time, ladies and gentlemen. The floor is yours if you want to say something about the co-op mode that we got shown today. Whether you love it, hate it, whatever it may be, let me know your thoughts down below. I love hearing what you guys have to say. I'm not sure if we're going to get our second video here of the day up. Like I said, it depends on when this video goes live and how it does and what all the other circumstances are like that. So if the second video doesn't go live, be sure to check back tomorrow for a giant breakdown of the trailer. Hopefully without any copyright strikes or anything. I'm going to try and do it as methodically and legally as possible. So if you did like the video, be sure to leave a like rating down below. Any shares to your Facebook, Twitter, and or MySpace if you would like that or is greatly appreciated. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe for the best of Call of Duty Advanced Warfare content. Any new news and information, you guys know exactly where to find it right here up on my channel. Thank you guys once again so much for watching. My name has been Nicole Espresso. As always, because I'm having a great day. I shall see you guys later. Take care and peace. Surprise, motherfucker.